Hi, I'm Dr. Michelle Lee, a board-certified ophthalmologist. One of the scariest diagnoses to receive is cancer, and as an ophthalmologist, I am always screening for various eye cancers. While primary eye cancer is extremely rare, it can be devastating if not treated appropriately. So today I wanted to go through some common eye and eyelid cancers that we see in the eye clinic. Cancer is a condition where healthy cells begin to grow uncontrollably, forming a mass, otherwise known as a tumor. A tumor can be dangerous if it spreads to other parts of the body. Cancers of the eye can be primary or secondary eye cancers. Primary eye cancers start in the eye and may or may not spread to other parts of the body. Secondary eye cancers, otherwise known as metastases, start from another part of the body like the breast, lung, and brain, and spread to the eye through blood vessels. So today we are going to talk about some common primary eye cancers. Basal cell carcinoma is the most common type of eyelid cancer, accounting for over 90% of eyelid cancers. This skin lesion typically appears in the lower eyelid and has a variety of appearances. These can look like a scaly patch of skin, a recurrent pimple or sore, or even a shiny, pearly, and smooth bump. These cancers have a low risk of spreading, but they can grow quite large and can cause disfigurement. The most common risk factor is excessive UV exposure, but also includes things like fair skin, radiation exposure, and immunosuppression, such as those who have had an organ transplant. We typically diagnose this by appearance, but confirm this by taking a biopsy and sending this to the pathology lab for microscopic analysis. After we confirm the diagnosis, we can treat this either by using medical therapy with a immune response modifier or complete excision to make sure all the tumor cells are taken out. This condition typically has a great prognosis with cure rates of up to 98%, but should be monitored for recurrence. The best way to prevent eyelid cancers is prevention with sunblock, sunglasses, UV protection, and wide-brim hats. There are other more invasive and less common cancers such as squamous cell carcinoma and sebaceous cell carcinoma that we always keep in mind when we look at eyelid lesions. The most common type of eye cancer I see in my cornea clinic is OSSN, otherwise known as ocular surface squamous neoplasia. This is a non-invasive proliferation of the top layer of cells, or epithelium, on the conjunctiva, which is the clear membrane over the white part of the eye. This lesion can have multiple appearances and can closely mimic a pterygium, which is a benign sun growth from the conjunctiva to the cornea. However, these cells are not normal cells, and various stains as well as the clinical appearance can alert us to this condition. Just like with eyelid cancers, we can perform a biopsy to remove the lesion and send it for analysis. Once the diagnosis is confirmed, we can treat medically or surgically. I like to treat most lesions medically with a topical chemotherapeutic drop. While there are some side effects, this is usually very effective and eliminates the need for further excision and surgery. In the past, surgery was the most common treatment option, and most surgeons would take out the entire lesion as well as a margin, followed by alcohol to kill cells, or cryotherapy, which is a technique where we freeze tissue. Any margins that are not cleared may require further surgery. The recurrence rate is high, so these lesions need to be observed regularly even after treatment. One of the most frightening types of eye cancers that we see is an ocular melanoma, which is a type of cancer that develops in the cells that produce pigment. Just like you can develop a melanoma on your skin, you can develop this on almost every layer of your eye, from your eyelids to your conjunctiva to the inside of your eye. Depending on where the melanoma is located, you might have unusual symptoms like changing color of your iris or conjunctiva, blurry or distorted vision, or flashing lights, but it's also very common to have no symptoms at all. We diagnose this based on an eye exam, and melanomas are usually detected during a routine eye examination, either with dilation or with a retina photo. After a diagnosis of melanoma is suspected, you might be sent to an ocular oncologist who is an ophthalmologist who specifically specializes in eye cancers. The ocular oncologist will then discuss options, which might include observation, plaque radiation therapy, or surgery. You may also need to get more imaging to make sure the disease has not spread to other parts of the body. Retinoblastoma is a cancer of childhood, where nerve cells in the retina have genetic mutations that begin multiplying. This tumor can invade into the eye as well as grow out of the eye, invading the lymph nodes or collections of immune system cells, and spread to the liver and bone marrow. This is a very rare condition but needs to be screened out immediately. Most pediatricians are trained to look for telltale signs such as a white pupil, inflammation, or misaligned eyes that might clue them into a possible diagnosis of retinoblastoma. But this cancer is best seen during a dilated eye examination and staged using imaging and testing. Treatment depends on staging but might include a combination of chemotherapy, surgery, cryotherapy or freezing to destroy cells, radiation, or laser therapy. You've probably heard of lymphoma, but did you know you can actually have lymphoma in your eye? Primary ocular lymphoma can develop inside the eye and affect the retina, which is the vascular wallpaper of the eye, the vitreous or the jelly that forms the eye, or the optic nerve, which is the nerve that connects the eye to the brain. We see this in those who have a weak immune system or with certain genetic mutations that increases the risk of having this type of cancer. Ocular lymphoma is extremely difficult to diagnose and is often misdiagnosed initially. Symptoms can vary from blurry vision, floaters, eye redness, sensitivity to light, and eye pain, and is diagnosed by performing a biopsy or a surgery called a vitrectomy, where a retina surgeon takes out a sample of the vitreous or that jelly inside the eye and sends it for testing. Treatment is usually a combination of chemotherapy and radiation therapy, and it is not uncommon for ocular lymphoma to spread to the brain, so treatment is sometimes targeted to the brain and spinal cord. Eye cancers are rare, but when we see them in the eye clinic, it is important to act on it quickly. The sooner you get diagnosed, the sooner you can get treated, and the better your outcome will be. So make sure you get your annual eye exam, and if you have any new or unusual symptoms, get it checked out. I hope you found this video useful. And if you did, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you at my next video.